Horsetails is proudly brought to you by the South Carolina Department of Agriculture. South Carolina, a true leader in the equine industry.
Wylie, we've had a lot of great times together, but I really feel like today is historical for me. Since I met you in my Marsh Tackies, I'm actually retiring Coco down to Brookgreen Gardens. You know, we've had a great relationship with Brookgreen through the years, taking horses down. And Andrea Dumont and myself had talked about whenever I had one to retire that she'd love to do that. So today we're taking Coco down to retire, and Coco's the mom of your horse, Faith.
That's right, and she's the mom of quite a few horses, David, as I understand. The one that's down there, Angel, that we'll be bringing back, and she's produced a lot of nice babies for you, and I know that the one I have, Faith, she's a good one.
Well, folks, today it's going to be Horsetails has been a journey for me. The Marsh Tackies have been a journey. And while in my quiet time of the morning, you know, we all hopefully will leave a legacy. And my legacy is going to be my faith and my family. But also how blessed I've been with these Marsh Tackies. Folks, as you see, she's a little unsure, but we'll get over that.
She's been nothing but a broodmare for a long time, right, David?
Right, and she, Wylie, was the favorite mount of Arnold Postel. And we've got a horse named in honor of Arnold Postel that our good friend Ashley Jones owned. And folks, these Marsh Tackies have a wonderful history. Today, we're gonna mix it up a little bit. We're gonna stop at a historical marker. We're gonna go on down to Brook Greens, and I got another little special treat that I'm not gonna tell you all about. We're gonna stop off and pick up my saddle today.
Oh, okay. So, that's a custom-made saddle for the PD Cowboy, isn't it?
Oh, absolutely. Absolutely. So, Wylie, you might, folks, you know, Cowboy can ride, but he ain't the greatest hand with a horse, so I'm probably going to turn this over here in just a minute to Wylie to load. Wylie, I'll get the gate if you want to.
All right. We'll see
take
how
the,
she
take
does.
Take the honors. Okay,
we'll see
very
how she
good.
Does.
She
good
knows,
girl.
She needs to know who's boss.
It's okay. Check it out. Good girl.
I should have brought some feed, because she's a feed addict. She knows the load. There you go. There you go. She knows. She knows. She knows. Give her a second. Good girl.
Good girl.
Good girl. Wylie got her loaded up. She was a little timid, but Wylie Bell, horse trainer extraordinary, got her. A little flaky latch there. Folks, next stop is a historical marker on Black Mingo Creek. Folks, as you know, General Francis Marion and his ragtag band rode these same type horses we're taking to Brookgreen Gardens today. And folks, we're gonna stop in there, and I'm gonna give you a little PD Cowboy history tidbit. Let's go. All my life, I've been obsessed with horses. I was curious and wanted to see other people's love for their horses and their stories. I'm David Grant, the PD Cowboy, and along with some incredible horse owners, I want to share the story of horses and the people that have a passion for them.
Horsetails is brought to you today by Circle Y. Fancy enough for the show ring, but tough enough for everyday use. Folks, when the PD Cowboy rides, he rides with Nationwide on his side. And by Warren Coker Hay Farms, Olana, South Carolina, for the best coastal Bermuda hay around.
You can't always be there to protect her down the road. Make sure the tires she's riding on will. With the revolutionary Michelin Premier Tire, even as it wears down over time, its safety doesn't, thanks to Evergrip technology. The Michelin Premier Tire. Safe when new, safe when worn.
Farmers are always planning for higher yields, more diversity, expanding opportunities. Nationwide and your local agent want to help your farm last through the generations. As the number one farm insurer in the country, Nationwide can help you achieve your goals. We stand for you.
Are you ready for a new ride? Anderson Brothers Bank has the right payment you've been looking for. If you enjoy a bank that gets to know you and your needs, then Anderson Brothers Bank needs to be your bank. Now is the time to stop by one of our 20 locations throughout the PD and coastal regions, where decisions are made locally. Right car, right payment, right now at Anderson Brothers Bank.
Good taste. It starts at the beginning. And when you take what was started right here in South Carolina and keep it here, we promise you'll notice the difference. Because fresh, locally grown food just tastes better. As you gather together with friends and family, be sure to enjoy the best the season has to offer. Choose certified South Carolina grown produce and products. It's a matter of taste.
Wylie, can you feel it? Is the hair standing up on the back of your neck? General Francis Marion and his ragtag band come across this bridge attacking Colonel William Ball. We're standing in front of history, and they were riding marsh tackies.
Well, David, I think the hair's standing up a little bit, but I think it's because you got me out here in the cold and in the rain.
Folks, as we know, we're carrying one of our marsh tackies down to Brookgreen to be retired, and she's of colonial Spanish descent, and we know that Francis Marion and his ragtag band rode marsh tackies. But this, folks, if you're coming out of Hemingway, going to Georgetown, it's South Carolina's full of historical markers. But I'm going to have to read this, Wylie, because you know I'm a... But when Marion, they said he did win. Marion's troop captured the enemy's gun, ammunition, and bagging. But folks, I love this. Their triumph, however, was the capture of blooded horses of the Tories. Wylie, strong bone Chickasaws raised in the limestone pastures around the springs of Utah. That's Utahville, where Santee is now, Wylie. History. Folks, like I say, when we made these horses, the state horses, we DNA'd them, but I wasn't quite convinced. I was a doubting Thomas. I went back and did my homework. Folks, history in the making, South Carolina.
Okay, folks, we're like Willie Nelson. We on the road again. Next stop, historic Brookgreen Gardens.
Hey, girl.
Good girl. Come on. This horse has a lot of history. I hadn't even, she's nothing a brood mare for me.
I figured we could swap ropes too so that you...
Yeah, that'd be fine.
I brought one for Angel.
Okay, good.
Folks, joining me now is Zandra DeMuth. She's a curator at Brookgreen Gardens. And it was very fitting with the mule in the background. She was saying, yay, we made it through the rain. Zandra's been a lot of years, me and you have been friends and bringing marsh tackies down here. Quite a journey. Jeanette Behringer put us together. And
2007.
Wow. So how many horses have we had back and forth?
Oh, we were just speculating. It's been at least like 12 to 14.
Right.
Our babies have come through here and grown up and gone off to training. And we've seen them in the races, and it's been really neat to watch them grow up.
It really has. We were discussing coming down here. This has been quite a journey for me personally. We've become friends and come down here to Brookgreen every year. It's just great. So what's the experience been like for Brookgreen and having marsh tackies down here for you?
It's been really nice to be able to educate people about marsh tackies. You know, a lot of people that are native South Carolinians don't realize that we do have a native horse, or now a state horse. And so when we first got the marsh tackies, I think it was a real educational thing for everybody. So we always point them out in our tours, and we talk about, you know, the history of them and how rare they are and the work you've been doing, and try to encourage them to follow the website and, of course, the show, and, you know, go to the races and things like that.
Bravo down here.
Yeah.
And I was coming back to pick him up, and there on the billboard on 17 was Bravo. And
Isn't that nice?
Oh, really? It really has. And I'll just mention in some pictures you was going over in the brochure that I have raised some really nice horses and sold some really nice horses. But every time I sold one, there was always, I don't know, a feeling, but that But once I found out where they went and how people enjoyed them, it was just always, I'm glad I did. And Jordan and Wylie, you have trained a lot of these little horses from down here. So what's it been like having horses from Brookgreen?
When they come from Brookgreen Gardens, they are nice and fat and sassy.
Yes.
But they are, I always know when they come from you guys, they're going to be very well taken care of. Yeah. And it's, you know, it was neat when I was in the races with Breeze, you know, you were on the sideline and you're like,
cheering her on.
Yeah, because you know, you have history with her and you know, obviously now she's in her forever home with me.
Mm-hmm.
Right, David?
That's true. Lock, stock, and barrel.
But I mean, I know how you probably get attached to these horses.
Yeah,
and then you have to say goodbye to them. But it's like David said, you watch them go on and see what they're going to do.
Yeah.
for their adult life.
Well, Andrea, the horse that we're retiring here today is just very special to me. It's the first time one that I've ever retired. And she's got a special story. One in Arnold Postel was one of the folks that was instrumental in really preserving the breed back in the day. Mm-hmm. A lot of great people, but I was fortunate enough to buy her from his estate. And never really used her for hunting because she's such a great brood mare. Because I've got some great babies off her, but she's Coco, and he was Arnold's favorite mount to ride. And I've got, like I said, a lot of her babies. So Angel's leaving here, which is one of her babies,
nice.
And Faith is one of her babies. So I'm just as excited and humbled to do that. I'm sure I'll be coming back down on vacation and bringing my granddaughter.
And we'll keep in touch.
Yeah, to do that. So thank you for everything you've done. And folks, like I say, the Marsh Tacky is our state heritage horse. And down here at Brookgreen, Andrew, you've got all kind of other colonial Spanish animals down here. Is that correct?
This exhibit, it's called the Dalton and Linda Floyd Domestic Animals of the Plantation, and we have all heritage breeds. Mm-hmm. So between the Marsh Tacky, of course, the mule's not really heritage, but they've been around forever and they've done all the work. We also have Tunis sheep. We have Red Devon cattle. And Dominique chickens too. So we try to keep with the heritage breeds down in this area to depict what would have been around in the plantation days.
Well, folks, the mule is the state heritage work animal,
if I'm correct. Yeah, because it got passed the same time
as the Marsh Tacky.
As the Marsh Tacky being the state heritage horse.
Good.
Yeah.
Well, folks, if you ever get a chance, you and our show goes worldwide. Come to Brookgreen Gardens, and especially around, anytime's a good time, especially around Christmas, the festival lights or something. You can go back in the archives with Horsetails TV and watch a couple of shows that we did down here. It was privileged to do. And folks, like I say, I'm going to give Andrea a great big hug because she's become a friend, and I'm just very excited and humbled for this to happen.
You're welcome.
All right, girl. I'll see you during vacations, okay? Thing. She's a little sporty on a hunter jumper, wouldn't she, Wylie?
Mm-hmm.
Maybe just tap her real easy, Wylie?
Yeah. Good girl.
And there you go, folks.
Horsetails is brought to you today by Andrews Mill Hay Farm. Folks, see David Andrews in Lamar, South Carolina for all your hay needs. Morrell Tire Service, Lata, South Carolina. See Rich Morrell and his fine family for all your automotive needs. South Carolina Horsemen's Council, the voice of the horse in South Carolina. And by Equestrian Images, making memories together.
Don't go racing around looking for your car loan. At Anderson Brothers Bank, we keep you on track from start to finish. Anderson Brothers Bank. Right car, right payment, right now.
Southern States carefully crafts every bag of Legends horse feed with the highest quality ingredients available. The Legends Superior line of specially formulated feeds will help keep your horses happy, healthy, and in peak form. You and your horse have a special bond. To keep that bond everlasting, Legends horse feeds can accommodate every type of nutritional need a horse might have. Legends, redefining what horse feed should be. Visit your local Southern States dealer to see which Legends feed is best for your horse.
From barbecue sauce to Benny wafers, members of the South Carolina Specialty Foods Association have a wide array of products that are sure to be a hit at your kitchen table.
South Carolina agriculture, it's a matter of taste.
There's a certain pride in knowing our food comes from a place we love, home. And when you consider all our state has to offer, you don't have to go too far to find great tasting food. So the next time you gather around a table, choose certified South Carolina grown, because here at home, it's a matter of taste.
Folks, the PD Cowboy arrives for the brand, and my brand is Carolina Fresh Food. We have a new product out on the range. So ride on into your local Piggly Wiggly or other fine retailer and ask for Carolina Fresh Premium Leg Quarter. And folks, if they don't have one in the corral, tell them to get cracking and call the old PD Cowboy and his elite posse of chicken wranglers. Carolina Fresh Foods, the name says it all. We are Fresh-alicious.
Wylie got Angel loaded up with a whole lot of drama, and this morning I had mentioned we got a special surprise. So the next stop gonna be UCLA, Upper Conway, Lower Aynor. Isaac Richardson has a surprise in store for the OPD Cowboy, so stay tuned.
Folks, it's been a historic day. We retired Coco down to Brookgreen Gardens, bringing her daughter back, which is Angel, and also, folks, I want to welcome Circle Y Saddler aboard the Horsetails as one of my fine sponsors. David Royal brought this saddle to me about a month ago, and I brought it down here to Isaac Richardson to get it detailed out. Got me a keeper for my lariat, got it rigged up so I can be dragging hogs and deer out the woods, and put me some nice strings on it, and also turned the stirrups for me. So folks, this saddle right here will never look the same. One day, it might earn the stripes. Folks, this is the first new saddle I ever owned 10 years ago from Bennettsville, down the road from you, Wylie.
That's right, when you said the sales.
Folks, this was a Circle Y trail saddle, and I hunted out of it for a decade. And folks, I tell you, that's a testament to how well Circle Y builds their saddles. It took everything that I dished out. And one day, I'm gonna have it totally refurbished, and hopefully one day there might be a little PD Cowboy. But folks, like I say, ringing out the old, bringing in the new. And also, folks, you know that I had a friend of mine to make this PD Cowboy scabbard. We're going to attach it to that later. But also, folks, this is the last dog collar my dad owned. I earlier took it off this saddle, and when I get home, I'll place it on this.
Oh, David, it's nice. I mean, you're going to be riding in style, the PD Cowboy. You know, you are a roughneck, but this is going to make you look classy.
Once again, like I say, a special shout out to David Roy with Circle Y Saddles coming aboard with Horsetails with a great sponsor. And folks, this was rigged up for me by Isaac Richardson from UCLA, Upper Conway, Lower Aynor. Folks, Isaac's on Facebook, but you can see the old PD Cowboy. Isaac's probably one of the better leather workers in the country. So if you need some custom stuff done, Isaac's your man. And folks, Like they say, you'll be seeing this saddle again, but not quite in this same condition.
Horse Tales is brought to you today by Coker Hay Pecan Shed, the only place to sell your pecans, South Carolina Department of Agriculture, and by King Street Auction Company, King Street, South Carolina, the best auction in the Southeast.
Yes, ma'am.
All right, folks, we're getting ready to unload Angel here. And she is a little bossy little thing, isn't she?
Yeah, she is. She don't have a lot of manners yet.
But. Yeah, she. Well, we're gonna fix that, folks. She's got some unusual markings. I was telling Wylie, look at that upside down question mark. So we're gonna question whether she's gonna be an angel. Like I say, she is kind of full of herself, folks. Got some good markings. See the shoulder stripings here, and leg markings. Got a lot of white. And we're getting ready to turn her loose with her full sister from a year ago, and we will. Probably let her get settled in for a couple months, and the next time you see her, we'll be hog hunting in the river bottoms of the Great PD. She's got her full sister here, and right over here has got her daddy, DP. So, folks, you're getting ready to see some horses kind of having a little reunion here.
Yep.
We left our mother at Brookgreen's, and the sisters will be reunited.
They'll strike normally in want to make sure I see that strike.
Since the first time she's had a big old pasture, she probably we don't know what grass is.
With that question mark.
And she's got a really good double mane.
Yep.
All she's really known is oak trees and acorns.
Yeah.
She is a little smaller, isn't she?
Yeah.
Wylie, a lot going on today, wasn't it?
Oh gosh, like you said, we've been to the beach and back and didn't even see the ocean.
Well, folks, it's been a great day. We left here 8 o'clock this morning. It was raining a little bit. Took Coco down to Brookgreen Gardens, picked her up, swapped her out with Angel, and folks, she's acting like a little angel right now. I'm a little surprised.
Yeah.
And so we're going to let her get acclimated for a couple of months, and then we're going to start her training. And I really thought they're going to be cutting up a little bit more than that. But, folks, it's been quite a journey for me with these marsh tackies. Like I say, I've been at it about 8 or 9 years, and this is the first horse I've been had the privilege to retire. Coco's going to have a great home down at Brookgreen. And, folks, when you're down at the beach, you need to stop in there and say hello to Coco.
Yeah, David, she's going to be, I think Brookgreen's garden's got a great, you know, great deal in this, because she's going to be there till the rest of her life, and she's a good representation of the breed.
Mm-hmm.
She's very typey, and you know, like you said, it's been a long journey for you, and it's been a journey for us, you know, coming out here knowing, you know, I walked up on your property 8 years ago and didn't know what I was getting into, and here we are, and I've got four marsh tackies thanks to you. And and when I met you, I didn't even know what a marsh tackie was.
Well, folks, we're all being a little cautious here.
You're
right. With the manners here. But Wylie, we was talking about our faith today, so we had, you got faith.
I got faith.
There's Angel.
That's right.
We've had grace.
And we've had mercy.
And we've had mercies.
And blessings.
And blessings.
Yep.
And folks, that about sums it up, doesn't it?
That is correct. We have had all those things in this journey.
And folks, until next week, keep your reins low and your hands quiet. As you can see, God has blessed this great country of ours and us too, Wylie.
See you next week.